Welcome to part 20. Are we at 25 now?
25.
Can you believe it?
Sounds about
right. Yes, 25. There's a lot of parts.
Travis, stop putting the numbers into the videos.
Yeah.
No, I will, because I never will. on the last one, we had to watch a whale cry, and now we're gonna load up our crew, and we're gonna show how big the world really is. Also, here's Ika's final move. I picked this up recently.
Wacky sound effects.
Oh, it gets more ridiculous, baby. I always kill jellyfish with my most powerful move. Just fuck them.
Her ultimate move is to turn the world to lava.
And then also create a nuclear explosion.
Damn, Ika. Okay, never mind.
It really didn't do it. And the jellyfish is still alive. So then I finish in the least dramatic fashion possible.
Donk.
Doink.
It did more damage than like a special move.
That was fun.
No, wait.
I'm exhausted. An ivy band, cool. Item pickup. That's what I get for having the fortune teller on my side. So also I'm going to show you a place where you can level grind, and is a little special location known as Looper Land.
Oh.
This section of sky in particular can only be crossed once you can cross the stone reefs. It's right here in the center space, right below the ice continent. You can only get it through the stone reef. The only enemy you can run into here are loopers. Loopers themselves make a ton of experience. So if you're looking to level grind, this is the place to do it. Because this is just my first encounter in this looper realm. And look at all the loopers.
Wow.
And here's a hint. None of them run away this encounter. I get to kill all of them.
Nice.
Now, was I imagining things on the map, or is there just like an entire column of nothing on the map?
There's a lot of... Well, the map itself hasn't been focused yet because I haven't flown over there yet. But we'll see items as we go.
Okay.
Me, Looper? No, you, Looper.
There's actually something very big on the map we'll see in a minute. Now keep on hitting me so then I can hit you with a rain of swords and end this. This is the stereotypical grinding area. What you do is you go into this area with the black flag equipped, because that always means you attack first, so it keeps them from running away. So then you just hit them with a wipe spell, clean them out, and get all the experience and just rinse and repeat.
How do you miss running?
That's my dance.
There's nothing for you to trip over.
You have no legs. How did you trip?
You can see how much experience I get from this one, just killing these guys.
How did one of them take half damage?
This is the most loopers I've killed ever.
Just stabs a cameraman in the groin.
It's about 1500 experience and 6000 gold. That's more than a boss.
Wow.
We also find a looper's nest. Where they all come from. We learn a little bit more about loopers.
Loopers, they are a thing.
They're a stupid creature. Also, first we want to go north here. You know how I mentioned there's giant creatures in this game? Dun, dun, dun.
My god.
Let's do it.
Starts grinding into me. This is Giant Looper.
Oh my god.
He's huge. The problem with... He's actually kind of difficult. Not in a difficult, like, he hurts way. In a difficult, he's really hard to kill. The reason is, and it's something that I forget when I get to this point, is that for one, it's really hard to hit him like a normal looper. On top of that, if you hit him with too much damage, he just flat out runs away.
God damn it.
I forget that. I moonstone cannon, he's just like, see, fuckers.
Also, how do you miss something that huge?
That's not moving much.
Also, he has 5 rings? What?
He jumps from ring to ring. So at some points, he'll actually dip below the clouds to where you can't hit him.
Oh my god.
Vi, seriously, why did we have to fly by him when he was about to do that? I just wanted to see what it was. Curiosity kills the vice.
I couldn't see, I got too many clouds in my eyes.
I really need some glasses.
I only have half of one. Assessing damage.
This is so much fun! Level it down. Nah, I'm good. See, this is where he escapes. Fuck you! He's gonna pop up in another ring. So if I fired him at that point, I would have missed.
This is the strangest encounter.
Hello! It's loopers, what do you expect?
I'm over here!
He's loving it. He's yucking it up. At this point, it's almost a waste of time to try to fire him outside of critical hit moves. We could use this move to... You can use Kirala to go to full HP, but I'm fine. I'm fine.
We only just ran into electricity breath. It's fine.
It's the Delphinus. It's fine. Did you like my glowing taint? Yes.
So we're gonna drive right back into it.
Take a mine. You see how these giant counters are. They're not generally difficult, but just this one is kind of a pain in the butt. Yeah, you don't want to kill this guy until you have a Kirala on your crew. Mainly because if you kill all four of the giant monsters in this world with Kirala on... the fortune teller on your crew, you're able to gain the title Vice the Extravagant, which you can only get if you kill all four of them with her on your crew.
Extravagant, what?
Yep. Unique title set just for that. I think it's the highest one.
Also, I see the knife on our bow.
Yep.
She must be going out with the guy who gives out the titles.
Give it to this guy. I owe him.
Not as extravagant as knife as Captain Harlock, but it's serviceable.
Harlock's is ridiculous.
It's perfect.
It's perfect, but ridiculous. Hi, I'm over here, guy. Gonna do anything? Moonstone, get him immediately, please. He's too cute, just kill him.
He's so cute, I want him to die.
See, I'm trying to kill him with this hit, which it might be possible in one hit, but he has a lot of health. Arc wheel torpedoes are ones I picked up from my ship shop.
Should have given him the drachma.
Booby went shame on.
Who's piloting this thing?
I say.
Let us get over here.
I think it was the steering wheel. Alright, let's try to kill him now.
You can see the torpedoes coming in.
Here we come. Oh, that tickles.
Oh my god.
So we got close.
He's gonna run, isn't he?
But he's gonna just bamf here in a second.
Thinking about it.
He looks down. Okay, now I'm actually hurt. My bad. I always feel like loopers were also the secondary stuffed animal that they wanted to make if this game franchise went anywhere.
Yeah, I could see that. Buy your giant looper doll. Only $50.
Import $5,000.
Sega import fee. You're a litter.
The Sega import fee. You'll see it in 15 years.
I feel like you could just park the Delphinus in this thing.
I feel like I could shank it. He's like, ah!
Okay.
Oh. Oh yeah, that'd be fun. Let's damage it little by little. The encounter will take 3 years.
3 videos later.
Nothing accomplished, great. I go back to Crescent Isle defeated. Mainly because at this point we can actually finish the engine so I can fly up and down.
What?
Hey, let's serious. After that, I'm tired now. What was that?
Okay.
No, he's like, I sprained my ankle. Don't show fear.
Let me just dislocate my jaw.
Now you know how I feel. I have to tell you that scenes after this have like 100% too much Marco in it. Yeah.
Which is 1 second.
Exactly. Hey, where'd you get out?
His existence is too much.
Yep. He's an eldritch being. If you see him, you lose your mind. But now we get to hang out back in town here. I don't know what to do with myself. I'm so excited. As we come back, though, the shop changed hands.
Hi.
I sense a coup d'etat. I was thinking if she had any new equipment, but I embarrassed her, apparently. Now where the other gun right went, it was actually into the cannon port and fixed that. Anyway, we got another meeting to go to. Look at how cool my island looks now.
It does look nice.
Looks better than my dad's.
Yeah.
You jealous, pups?
Yes, I am. This is my island now, son.
Oh, pirates in your robbing ways. So all that's left is the yellow and the silver one. The silver one is currently with the Sylvite Elders. We don't necessarily have to worry about that one right now. We just gotta get the one from Valua, which sounds considerably more difficult.
Do we really have to? I mean, Valua's just gonna fuck off until now. We have the rest.
I guess the idea is that no one can get to the Moon Crystal right now, but they feel like eventually someone could, so they might as well secure it just to make sure.
Or I guess the queen could be like, yeah, fuck this, summon the yellow giant.
Well, at this point, the issue is that if last time we went here, the place was sealed in an area called the Maw of Tardis, which was indestructible. Not even the Valuan ships could break through it. But with the new engine, we can fly underneath Valua, which has a set of caverns that'll let us fly underneath the Maw of Tardis to enter it from there.
This doesn't seem like a good idea.
No idea is a good idea, I see.
Yeah, that sounds like Vice.
I swear I got... Oh, never mind. He was like he's about to punch somebody. Never mind.
Enrique, get over here.
With a scorpion blade. Get over here! Sleepy time. Okay, I'm good.
Oh my god, you have a picture of your dad on your desk?
And I have a pirate, random like kid's pirate flag behind my bed.
Well, he also looks...
So this is what you can do with the new engines. Above the clouds! So here's what's cool about flying above the clouds. For one, no obstacles. You can fly over everything. Reason two, it's cool. No enemy encounters above and below the clouds.
Oh, that yes. Sounds so nice.
It's easy to get to places now, and you don't have to fight shit. This is truly the moment where you feel free. Also, there's a shit ton of discoveries above and below the clouds.
That what's-his-fuck can't get to.
Yeah, look at those. I can fly over the Dark Rift. I can fly over the Stone Reef.
You can fly into the moon.
I can fly towards that satellite.
I'm just fully expecting the giant looper to come back. Holy shit, that is a satellite.
You get the feeling that the society before got wiped off by the rains of destruction was super advanced. So if you fly kind of north where the ice area is, you'll find this house floating above the clouds.
And a yeti is here.
Let's take a visit. So there's a dude in here we want to talk to, and there's a Cham as well. I'm stuck on the stairwell. People, stop teasing me, where is it? You want to come back here for one, there's a Cham up here. Two, there's a new crew member up here, too.
This raises questions. How is he alive?
It looks like they are pumping air in here and pressurizing. I think we got this guy. Ichimus.
How does he get supplies?
I imagine he flies down to buy supplies and flies back up, maybe?
Maybe.
You're weird. I like you.
Join my crew, please. You're weird enough for it. You do want to get this guy, though, because on top of the fact that he's a medic, he will sell you healing supplies back in town. The only way he will join your crew, though, is if someone on your crew knows Rizalem. So that's why I devoted so much time to Fina having the silver crystal. Other than the fact that, for one, it is a useful thing to have, but also we can pick up this dude. Now, he basically told us no, he's not going to join our crew. So what do I do to get him to join our crew? We go outside.
Looper grind.
Stupider. We go back into the building.
Oh, we already know it, and he just didn't trigger the flag, didn't he?
Nope, you actually have to talk to him twice, so you trigger by leaving and then coming back.
Oh, god damn it.
Gonna ask you again.
Did you have 2 seconds to think about it? Cool. He's just saying, I went up here to learn more about the Rizlum spell, and you're like, well, my people know it. He's like, cool, I'll join you. That's nice. You get him on your team, he will sell you medical equipment, but he also sells it at a cheap price, too. So he is very useful.
A heart full of wisdom and love. No. Not vice.
You just see like a sociopathic look on his face. Like, you're right. All right. Now, also flying above the Dark Rift, we go to the silliest place on the planet. Welcome to the bird party. They're literally probably like they're drunk on fruit.
I'm very confused right now.
It's a cham around here somewhere, and you're about to get more confused here in a second.
Crush, kick, stomp.
It's hard because you're trying to mash without talking to the birds because they're just saying the same thing. Look at this party. Got some passed out people and.
Chirp, 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 chirpery.
I am hungry, so come here and arm. You're having the time of their life. Where are you, you damn cham? I don't want to talk to these birds. I'm not. This is how I am at a party. Like, everyone's partying. I'm just like, look at this corner. It looks really nice. Is there a dog I can pet or something?
This is a very cozy corner of the room.
Now, if you did notice, there's a giant one. We want to go talk to him, too.
Vice the hero.
He's a crew member, isn't he? I'm right, aren't I? This idiot is a mascot, isn't it?
Hey, this person's selling squid. Chirpity chirp chirp chirp. What do you want? So this is the ham chill hermit.
I'm still right, aren't I?
No. Luckily, he does not, but he has another purpose. If you talk to him, he's able to do kind of math to figure out how many treasures you found, how many fights you've had, how many have you run away from, and he gives you kind of grades on them. So let's find out the way I fight to see how it is. So he knows it down to the T. So he knows that the number of times I have engaged in battle, 347 times.
Yikes.
About average, yeah. The only times I've run away, once, because it was an encounter that I couldn't win. Because I was just Ike and Fina at the time, and I had to. This is how many times each character has died. Fina's died the most by one.
Gilder hasn't died.
Too cool. Now we get to find out my treasure hunting skills. I haven't been doing a very good job at that, but... I see, it's just really impatient or something. And the amount of fish you found, 52 kinds of fish. You hate fish or something, don't you?
No, I love fish. In my stomach.
Moonfish, where are they? Tell me now. Just start shaking them. I let the old man get back to his business.
Of scaring the tree.
I've never been more pleased to be wrong in my life.
Oh, and look, there's a giant enemy above Ixataka. A giant bird. Speaking of birds, this one joins our crew. Now we kill him.
Darn.
Means the same thing.
Look at the size of those feet.
There's no reason for those talons to be that huge.
For shanking. It's a shank bird. Sword falcon.
It's a rock.
I got a rock.
Rock gnome? No, we killed that.
This is probably out of all four of the giant creatures you can fight, probably the strongest, just based on the amount of damage it can do.
I'm actually surprised to see this enemy in this game.
It's a non-fish thing.
Yeah,
It's something in the sky that's supposed to be in the sky.
Exactly.
Well, what's wrong with the bird hermit?
Well, he's not in the sky.
But no, this game takes itself totally seriously.
Yes.
It doesn't look like he's wearing a neckerchief or something.
Yeah.
Maybe he's on his way to a party.
Or he's wearing like a bib getting ready for lunch.
Yeah, on a ship.
He's going to Gordo's place.
I got reservations 3 months ago! Ah!
Damn you, Vice.
This screams at us. You go back to Vice's ears are bleeding. I can't hear anything.
Everybody else is just like, thank God, now I don't have to hear him.
What? See, the red part is mean you're going to have a bad time, so... Luckily, I have a ton of complete kits. That negates any damage you tried to do, buddy. Complete kit completely heal you. Completely. You can be at 1 HP and go to full health.
The last part of your...
And the nice thing is they're super cheap, too.
So, we've been talking about the knife on our ship, but what?
Ow. Yes, the knife.
Yeah. Did we ever use the knife, or was it just exclusively for getting to the ice temple?
Pretty much. It was used to break through stone reefs and break into the ice.
Ugh.
But it also looks super cool, too.
It does. I just kind of wish we could crash it into enemies, you know?
Shake attack!
I just really want to see this thing impaled on our ship.
We should just rip off its head and stick it on the front, kind of like a mask. People are fierce with this dead bird head. And this goofy dolphin.
Clean it and dry it out first, obviously.
Nah, I like the stink. It reminds me of Victory.
Vice the sadist.
As his eyes are pointing in two different directions, looking at the sun.
Burning up.
So in this one, we do have an option to be able to hit it with the Moonstone Cannon. You want to hold your position for this guy, or take him straight on. I forget which one. Fuck it. Whatever I said. That was a complete guess, so let's see. I guessed right, yay! Let's kill it.
Never stops being funny.
It does look cool with the knife dropping down like that, though.
Yeah, it really does. Weird bit of thing I always had when viewing this game, every single time I see this game is always with Vice piloting his dad's ship. And I'm a little bummed out that you don't get to pilot that, but then you see the Delphinus, you're like, oh, this is better.
This is way cooler. The ship you have isn't very piratey, but the fact that you just get the ship that can destroy anything does make a little more sense in the overarching plot.
Yeah.
Although I did enjoy, with the Little Jack, that you had to kind of think a bit more when you fought enemies stronger than you.
Yeah, because you're basically piloting a dinghy.
This one, you basically can go fist for fist with really anything.
Did you ever get to pilot your old man's ship, or was that just for, like, the beginning of the game?
I was just flying back to Sailor Island.
Oh.
You know, thinking about it, it may not look piratey, but what's more piratey than stealing the ultimate flagship of the enemy?
It represents piratey. Thank you, torpedoes. I'm going back to my home planet, see ya. I forgot it died that way, that's great.
Somehow I feel like you should have showed that off first rather than a bird costume, man.
They're both good, come on.
Where are these leaves coming from?
They're floating up from the green continent I'm above.
Huh.
Even the green continent looks like South America. Now here we are below. Now below, unfortunately, we can't fly through things easily, but it enters a lot of different areas. Here's a lore ship. This is the ship that crashed that had Remember the mentioned stories about the ship crashing? This is the ship.
Ah, this is the Pistole story?
Yep, Piastol and...
Piastol, that's right.
And the Doctor's story, too. We got this little circle here, which I'd ignore. Now, if you go to the Ice Temple from below, you can see it. But also, if you enter it from below, you go to a special area to pick up another Moonberry that you can't get otherwise.
Huh.
Also where you get another Moonfish. You can also take a shortcut there back to the beginning of the temple if you want to go through the temple if you miss something. But we're here just for those items.
It's a good thing you didn't miss any Moonfish.
It took some work.
This is the kind of extra I really like.
Where the hell is it?
Let me use my lids.
And see, like, I was even kind of thought, like, ah, it's no big deal getting all the Moonfish. Then I went, oh yeah, there's story parts that have to deal with the Moonfish. Shit. Gotta get them now. And plus, now that you have the ship that can go literally anywhere, you can pick up things you've missed. So now I get to sell all my discoveries that I've picked up since then.
Will I ever get to enjoy my book?
Nah.
Some of those other ones are worth quite a bit.
The Maroon Island is 5.
Mainly because it's already been discovered.
Ah, okay.
Depending on when you turn in these items, affect their range of value. But now I have 31 discoveries, which means I can finally get the final member of my crew.
We know who it is.
Also pick up some jellyfish on the way there.
You must really hate fish.
I do. I hit it with my ship.
I love the thought of Gordo standing outside his bistro, looking up, and you just descend from the sky.
Hey, it's good. You're just failing. Get in. So he will only join your crew if you have 30 discoveries. I have 31, so get your ass on my ship. I hate you.
What are you tightening?
He's grinding pepper, I guess.
Into his fist?
Onto his lap, yeah.
Ah, yes, cause my dick to tingle. So now we get him on our crew. He can replace Tika Tika as a lookout. Let me show you something beautiful now from all that work.
Do you really want to replace Tika Tika, though?
Full crew. Ah, yeah.
Domingo.
Ryukan.
Domingo.
Go away. Let's see the difference between them. This increases the torpedo's hit percentage, which is really good. This increases chance of delivering critical hits, which is also really good, so we'll have Domingo on there.
Ow.
Although I think in the long run, I think Tika Tika would probably be more useful, but I've had him on there for a while, so he deserves a break. Now, let's go into the Maw of Tardis upside down. The easy way to find it, you find those dancing lights, which are another discovery right there. And you'll notice this little patch right here you can fly into. Into Valua's sphincter, apparently.
It even looks like one. Ugh.
Even called the Maw of Tardis, which does not help. This is the second and final ship dungeon.
You think there'd be more.
Yeah, you'd think so. This one's actually relatively short, too, so I kind of wish there were more of them. Like, maybe one more kind of really in-depth one, but oh well.
I think the map design of random scattered islands kind of prevented that.
Yeah, a little bit. Like, this is a pretty neat designed area, comparatively. I mean, there's not a whole lot of visual to it, but it just seems so large in scope. Plus, it might give you the idea that possibly the ancient people of Valua mined this place for its yellow stone rather quickly.
Yeah, it looks like they just emptied it.
Enemies around here, too, are particularly tough. And they're unique. Like, you only run into these enemies in this area. I'll show them when I actually get to one. There are a couple of outreaching paths in different directions. I do lead into dead ends, and there are some treasures you can pick up. Nothing really to write home about, so I've been kind of ignoring them. You can easily get lost in here, though. Just from the design, it's kind of similar and directionless, though, unfortunately.
I do like the sense of scale, though. It actually does feel like a huge fucking continent.
The sense of scale in this game is done really well, because you realize you're flying in a very big ship. You're in that little compartment at the very tip top of the ship.
You do move on a dime, but...
Oh, yeah.
If it was any slippery, it wouldn't be quite as fun.
Yeah. Sometimes, I guess.
You'd be running into too much shit is the problem. There's these guys.
Are those what I think they are?
Microbial diseases, yes.
Shrimp. Oh.
They're backwards right now. They'll turn around and give you a better look.
I thought they were like those, I think they were called cones or something? A really ancient creature? I can't remember the name.
I know what you mean, but they are based on that for sure. You can tell.
Ah.
They have a lot of HP, too, is the problem. And the issue is also because they're yellow enemies, they do also know Drillin. Drillin lowers attack and defense of the people that it casts on, so it's a little obnoxious. But they're not too tough.
When you have Rain of Swords.
Rain of Swords is not going to do as much as I would hope.
I'm trying to figure out what those other things are.
They look like anglerfish, a little bit.
I'll take care of it, don't worry.
I killed something.
This starts doing a really kind of cute, quiet clap. Yay! Just everyone else like, what are you doing? We need to kill this thing. Oh, sorry. So also just normally attacking can lower your stats too. Go figure.
What a shocking revelation.
Shut up.
And then I was kicked out of the group.
Moonstone can.
There's a crater in California.
I don't know where in California, so I'll just aim for all of it.
Great.
Sorry, Thorn.
Damn. Over there.
Yeah, I can tell this guy just slows things down. Really cool design, though, and this is the only place you can actually run into a character of this design. Which at this point, especially in older RPGs, you'd see a lot of repeats.
Yeah.
But the fact they can still surprise you with unique enemies is nice.
This does seem like a good place to put it, because the area does have kind of a primeval feeling to it, and this is a very ancient-looking monster. An utter victory.
Also, that's a really good point, because this game does a very good job of putting treasure and monsters where it makes sense. You'll especially see it later in the game, where there'll be enemies that you might have seen at different points of the game that fit the location they're in. These enemies, you only run into an area that's subterranean and can only be entered like by very few, in this case your ship, so they're almost ancient. There'll be some other enemies that match that profile as well, besides that crystal I crashed into. But they also do it with items too. There's certain items you pick up in treasure chests that make sense that they're in that area. So the way they put the thought into that is, I appreciate it.
Wait, did we turn around?
Nope, this is the end of the temple.
Oh, okay. Because the beginning had a save point and I was really confused.
I was kind of worried too, but then I realized, oh, I entered through a sphincter. It would look different.
So we're going at the esophagus now. Sweet.
Or the butthole. Looks like we're going through the cheeks. We enter this big room. Weird. Let's take a look. Something's gotta be around here.
The entire Valuan army just turns and sees you.
Hi there.
I like this slow reveal.
What?
Ooh, God.
Pinchy, pinchy.
There he is.
What do you want?
It's active?
No, it's sleeping. Yellowgar.
Yellowgar. Nice.
But of course, put him to sleep. Just take the stone, but don't wake him up. I'm sure that'll work. And of course, he automatically wakes up before we even make a mistake. And yes, he is active.
Detect idiot. Kill.
D- Damn it, I thought we should leave Aika behind.
What?
So here's just an inside fact to me recording this. After I beat him the first time, I turned off my game, and then I forgot I didn't save, so I had to fight him twice. This just shows how strong he is, though. I think that no one could break through, he's just like, ah, get out of my way.
You know, you gotta realize that Vice must be a special kind of annoying if the Queen of Alua didn't activate this thing, but Vice managed to.
That is a good point.
Like, oh, Queen of a country, not quite enough. Oh, 15-year-old, die.
Well, fair, he's like 17, but still. The interesting thing about these last two temples, we went to a temple, but we didn't fight a Gigas. This one, we didn't go to a temple, but we're fighting a Gigas.
Oh, yeah, good point. I do like the design. This looks neat.
This one looks unique compared to them, and he also has a multitude of very heavy-hitting attacks. Don't underestimate this guy. This guy can definitely stack damage on you very quickly.
Thunder is sound, not lightning.
Science!
So now we're going to get a straight fist fight with a giant bug.
We could take him.
Oh yeah, absolutely. It's not like I said I beat him or anything. I like his tail too.
Doing the worm.
It almost looks like a parasite.
It does look a lot like a parasite. But the funny thing is its legs almost work like conductors.
Yeah.
Like the tips of its legs.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking too. It really is an interesting design. The start of a mighty shit battle. Everybody assessing damage.
Preparing their shit.
Nope, we haven't been hit yet.
Check again, please.
Just gotta make sure.
There's his first attack. And many of his attacks actually come out of his back, so his back is a dangerous area.
Wow, that's a huge attack.
That's his weaker attack, too.
Again, scale.
Yep. They also show scale through damage, because the strongest hit I can do with my best attack is like 8,000 damage with the Pirate's Wrath. And he's hitting as a joke sometimes for like 10,000, so... So that shows you a sense of scale that maybe, like, Vice probably couldn't beat a ship up. The ship would beat him up, at least.
So hell really that bad? Oh yeah, it kind of is.
You want to keep an eye on your health. You want to keep it above half, because you never know when someone's going to hit you with an attack that hits for a surprising amount of damage. Especially later in the game. I feel like this would be very hard to fix.
It's just electricity, man.
Rub a complete kit on it. Electricity's pulsing through them.
Everybody's just doing a shake.
Nope, I'm still fine. Okay.
What's his face is just in the corner saying you didn't pay me to get electrocuted.
This is where I leave, apparently. Oh wait, I'm fighting something, shit. This is its more powerful attack. Laser!
Okay, wow.
Voltigar.
Fired my dick!
So you can see it uses the tip of its legs as a conductor.
No.
What happened? I couldn't hear you.
You were mentioning before that under these circumstances you wouldn't see Vice beating up a ship or a Gigas, but I feel like if we saw this in more of a modern setting, you would be like, oh, we gotta land the Delphinus on top of the thing, and then we gotta go inside its center and then kill it, because we're awesome.
It'd be interesting, but it'd be dumb, because you'd just be like lightning strike and fry them all.
Yeah. This seems a lot more intense because we need a ship that costs the entire capital income of a country to beat it.
Yep. Now, this one, it gave you the option to attack from above or below. Definitely recommend below because it gives you more attack options, and although it looks very intimidating to fly towards its claws, it hits you with less attacks that way.
I was going to say, isn't it a bad idea to go from the bottom because that's where the giant laser comes from?
That's what you'd think. In fact, you mean this move?
Yes. Because look at this. If we attack from the bottom, we're fucking dead.
I know we're fat, yeah.
We're just regular dead.
It's fine.
Do we lose Marco? I'm still here. Oh.
Blame a guy for trying.
Make sure he's dead immediately. That's checking on damage. Is Marco still here? Yes. Is he still here now? Yes.
I can't get rid of this damage.
Why are you asking me whether I'm here?
Is it crawling?
Kinda. It doesn't know what to do with its legs.
Kind of a weird thing I noticed about the Delphin is I noticed that atop the cannons are like little rectangles, which I'm assuming are flat cannons, so I was... It'd be kind of neat if there was a fight where you had to fight smaller things atop the Delphinus. Not like creature small, but like...
You mean like a turret scene?
Yeah, well, kinda. Like, what's a good example? I want to say Final Fantasy VIII's ship battles were at one point they had to fight off anti-air ships on their boat.
Yeah, you can tell we're not really doing a whole lot of damage to this guy. Lucky that we're fighting these Gigas in weakness order. But there's the hint. We need to knock it off balance before it hits with its most powerful attack. It's important that your Moonstone Cannon is fully charged for these moments, because if you notice, you fire it on his red turn.
Yeah.
So you basically kind of bite the bullet. If you don't have that, then you don't knock him off of balance, which gives him a chance to pummel you harder. But if you do manage to hit him with the Moonstone Cannon, guess what? Next turn, you get to do the same thing again. The charger focuses.
So you're basically getting an attack opportunity twice for the cannon.
Yep.
This is going to be good.
For this particular fight, it's nice because they give you an opportunity, depending on good decisions, to fire your Moonstone Cannon 3 times in a row.
Wow.
So it's, especially for this guy who has a ton of HP, it's very useful. It keeps the fight considerably shorter than it usually is.
I'd imagine if you shoot the Moonstone Cannon 3 times in a row, it just gets so hot that the front of the ship melts.
Imagine you just fall out eventually from the heat, just melts through the frame. The only thing they designed is a way, if you look underneath the ship, it has these huge segments of exhaust at the bottom.
Yeah.
I like how they put that thought into the design.
Mm-hmm. Same thing with Voltigar. Or wait, is that his name? No.
Yelligar.
Yeah, that's it. Ah, names.
Oh, trust me, it's hard to remember all their names. I just remember because some of them are silly, like Blueheim. And the sad thing is I don't remember the name of the red one. I just remember him as Gurr.
Yeah, that was my fault.
There's Gurr, there's Grendel, Blueheim.
I think it was Geertab.
Yeah, I think it was Geertab or Geertab, something like that. Rocknum, though he does have a different name, because it's only mentioned once for the Purple Gigas, and now Yelligar.
Did it knock it off balance?
Even though it's in the air?
See, guys, I told you, but you won't let me use it anymore.
Whatever Moonstone can.
Oh, there's the third attack of opportunity.
Depending on decisions, of course, or actions. I got plenty of spirit points at this point, and the way you end up keeping it that way, the biggest thing people, inexperienced players make at this fight is they start using their cannons too much. And when you do that, you use up all your spirit points, so when you actually need them, you can't use them. So my trick, never fire cannons unless you're on a critical turn. Because you'll do tons of damage that way anyway, and it'll make up for all the misses you make when you don't do that. Plus you'll be able to use the Moonstone Cannon anytime you want.
I'm a little sad that you didn't get to keep the harpoon gun on the Delphinus. Because then I'd like to imagine the circumstance where you harpoon something just to put it in front of the moonstone cannon.
Or pull it in at point-blank range and fire.
Yeah. Or pull it into your knife.
And then melt off the front of the ship.
You just really want that knife to be used.
Yes.
I feel like structurally, that would be a bad idea.
Yes, but rule of cool.
Yeah, rule of cool. The next encounter, I'm just preparing to shoot him with the laser again and just take this asshole down.
God, from the angle of approach, it almost looks like you're going to pull off something from Independence Day.
Hello, boys! I'm back!
It's okay.
Would have been a really different movie.
Listen, guys, look how off balance he is right there. Look at him off balance. Doing the same motion you did before. Now, this is where we have a decision. You'd think keeping an attack on him would be the right decision, but we actually want to stay back. Because otherwise, he hits us with an attack and counters. And next turn, we get to use the Mr. Cannon again. Great. Let's see if we can kill him this turn. That'd be funny.
Nope. Why didn't you sink the torpedoes with the cannon?
Because I want them hit the hit on the same turn.
Wouldn't it, if you did on turn one, then torpedo on turn two, or... wait.
Well, the turn four has a critical hit.
Oh, okay.
So if I hit with both items, it'll hit more damage with both of them.
Okay, I gotcha.
Watch him struggle.
Watch him bleed.
Yeah, as you notice, if you make the right decisions, this fight isn't too tough. And as long as you have a ton of complete kits, you're fine.
What's there left to bleed? We're evaporating it.
And instantly cauterizing any wounds.
If it had blood.
Yeah.
These things honestly kind of feel more like robots.
I was wondering that, if we were to actually just jab the front of the Delphinus into him. Doesn't seem like there'd actually be anything that would come out.
Probably on Rocknum, because they said he was a creature turned into a Gigas. I feel like everything else was artificially constructed. They were never creatures, they were just robots.
Yeah, you can kind of see that with Gyrtab and Grendel. Especially with Grendel.
Yeah, Grendel just doesn't have a physical form that makes any sense.
Grendel is Gumby.
Still think he's pretty cool, but
yeah,
not as cool as the other ones. Look at how much damage I did with that.
Yeah.
By doing it that turn. That's why you wait for your critical turns. Just give up, buddy. You can't heal yourself. I can heal myself. Let's just end this on turn one, shall we? But I want you to do Moonstone Cannon. Go for it. I just have this weird thing that always has to be Vice doing the Moonstone Cannon. Although I think it'd be cool that if you did it with other characters, they would say Moonstone Cannon Fire.
Oh, they don't? Oh. No.
So remember when Blueheim just crashed into the mountain when it died? Wonder what's helping the Yellowgar when he crashes. I got a new sword for Vice, too. Yeah.
The thing had a sword on it. Where?
How do we get it is the bigger question.
Especially when this happens.
Bye.
It's a Death Star.
Ike, don't.
Yeah, Vice looks kind of pissed.
Ike, how dare you?
Fina, how dare you too?
Oh, there's the sword. So, checklist on Titans.
Ow. Ow.
We put Gyrtab to sleep. Grendel's in a river.
Yep.
What's after that? That was...
Blueheim.
Blueheim got crashed into a cliff.
Rocknum died. And now Yellowgar blew up. There's only one moonstone left, and it's the silver one. But now I get this kind of impending sense of sadness from Fina. Because guess what, Fina? You finished your mission. Yay!
Now she could be a pirate.
No, she has to go home. Her job was to get the moon crystals and then bring them back. Oh, hey, I guess the fifth chair was for him.
How the hell did you get in here? What are my guards doing?
Like a vice talked, but it was Fina making the noise.
Just, he's about to say something and got interrupted. He turns around. Who's captain here? I'm sorry. My eye hurts.
Looking at you. Get the fuck off my island.
So now we go have a super duper party.
Of sleeping.
Our flag flies with pride. We got talking chickens. There they're all displayed to kind of show the awesome things we've done. We told all the stories to Gilder and catch him up.
Just makes me want to get freaky.
Up till now, just been doing it out of habit.
Ismael shows up, I'm here to do it. Yeah, Fina, you get to go home. Yeah, I bet you're looking forward to that. Yeah. See, look at that enthusiasm. She's got it, she's got it. Plus, we never really answered where Fina came from. Jumps out the window.
Follow me!
That's where I'm from.
Oh yeah, Ramirez. We haven't seen much of him.
Yep, he's also a Silvite. But the Great Silver Shrine is her home. So the most powerful Silvites escaped in a ship above the sky.
And then everyone else just copied the idea.
And Fina crashed it. We've never gone to the surface, have we?
Nope, not yet. So, I mean, but you have to think. We mentioned that the world was pretty much wiped out and destroyed by what's known as the Rain of Destruction, which was moonstones just pummeling the earth and destroying it. So probably everything at the surface is just destroyed ancient civilization. That's it.
You make it sound really exciting, though.
Lots of moonstones.
God, if I was Vice and I heard that, I'd be foaming at the mouth.
He is, kind of.
He jumps out the window.
I'll get there myself. The big thing is that we're thinking, how is she going to get back home? We have to get Fina's ship back.
I thought that it... Oh no, wait. Valua captured it.
No, it crashed.
I thought it blew up.
It crashed. It went below the clouds. So.
Ah, okay.
And then Parver's thinking, that's okay, I want to stay here. But we're like, no, wait. Don't get too hasty. We got to find the ship. Meanwhile, you said you haven't seen Ramirez in a while, so here you go.
Meanwhile, evil. What was that? Death Star Island?
Dangrel Island. They're currently building a base that can go below the clouds. So they're trying to get to the ships themselves.
I'd like to see the steel rigging that makes that coat bigger than what he is.
It's a badass coat, whatever it is.
He's like a Martin Joe, he's really just skinny and sick.
It's an iron lung.
Emphasis on iron! An iron lung and an iron fist.
That is how I rule this land.
So we're getting a sense from Galcian that he plans on betraying Vlua for his own personal ambitions. And if you have a feeling that Ramirez has a little bit of a crush on Galcian.
I like your picks.
I like your coat.
I like those weird tassels.
I end this episode with a nap sound.
Dun, dun, dun.
Annette, we're in the world.
Bean is going to stay here all the time, and Calthian's not going to murder us.
Bean is my friend forever.
So next time, we're going to see what we can do about going underneath the clouds to find Fina's ship. So we'll get to explore even more of the world.
Out of everything in the game, that's probably what I'm looking forward to the most.
Yeah. Why do I get the feeling that we're going to approach it in the same way we approach the Ice Temple?
Crash into it. Things from this point start to get pretty fast-paced, too. Like, the plot really starts to kick up from this point.
If that guy, that dumb fuck Rudolph, I forgot his name already.
Rudolph? Ramirez?
No, the other asshole. Alfonso?
Yeah, Alfonso, hee-hee guy.
Yeah, hee-hee. If we don't find the guy that he threw into the surface and he's still alive, I'm going to be pissed.
He's just eating ancient civilizations to keep alive.
You guys want some? I killed a dinosaur.
Well, tune in next time to find out.
Moonfish.
Moonstone.
Oh my god. All those hunting for moonfish.
I hate fish.
But yeah, the bird said so. The bird man. Bet you didn't think you were going to see an old man in a bird suit today.
I did not. That caught me so off guard. I was expecting another mascot. Not... What the fuck was that?
And it did the best thing to reveal it, too, where it shows back for a while, and then it suddenly jerks around and says, old man face.
That broke me. I was so done after that.
That is the kind of majesty you can expect from Skies of Arcadia Legends.